Doki Doki bedeutet so viel wie Herzschlag oder Herzpochen, wurde mir im Twitch-Chat verraten. Okay. Ja. Erklärt schon ein bisschen, was mit dem Buchclub hier auf sich hat. Aber gucken wir mal, was Monika zu sagen hat. Man, I'm the last one here again. Don't worry, I just walked in too. Were you practicing piano again? Yeah. You must have a lot of determination. Starting this club and now picking up piano. Well, maybe not determination, but I guess passion. Remember that the club wouldn't be here if it wasn't for all of you too. And I'm super happy that you're willing to help out for the festival too. I can't wait for the festival. It's gonna be great. Okay. Weren't you complaining about it just yesterday, Natsuki? Well, yeah. I'm not talking about our part of the festival. But it's a whole day of school where you get to play and eat all kinds of delicious food. You sound a bit like Sayori all of a sudden. Monika, do they usually have fried squid? Squid? That's a pretty specific thing to look forward to. Come on. Are you saying you don't like squid? You, of all people? I didn't say I don't like it. Besides, what do you mean by you of all people? Because it's right in your name. Monika. That's not how you say my name at all. Also, the jokes makes no sense in translation. Danke. Never mind. Das habe ich, also ich hatte einen, bei Steam habe ich halt, bevor ich das gespielt habe, ein paar Reviews gelesen, halt, die halt als nicht Spoiler markiert waren. Und einer meinte sich auch, wenn man solche Spiele wie Stanley Parable mag. Und bis jetzt hatte ich ja noch nicht viel, aber das ist natürlich jetzt schon zwei, dreimal so die vierte Wand durchbrochen, wie man sagt. Einmal das mit dem Safe Game, jetzt der Witz über eine Übersetzung und da war noch eine andere Sache. Irgendwie mit der Monika stimmt irgendwas nicht. Okay, das wird jetzt ab und zu, sonst noch nicht wirklich häufig, ist eigentlich relativ wenig bisher. Wir spielen jetzt schon, was nicht, anderthalb Stunden oder so. Aber ich würde schon vermuten, dass es wahrscheinlich sowas jetzt häufiger wird. Grüße an Jasmin übrigens im Twitch-Chat. Ist auch gerade reingeschaut ist. Ika heißt auf Japanisch Tintenfisch, sagt der Blackout. Weißt du das eigentlich alles oder hast du es nachgeguckt oder so, weil du vorhin das mit dem Doki Doki auch schon geschrieben hast? Auf jeden Fall danke, Ika. Tja, haben wir auch das gelernt. Let's just focus on our event for now, okay? Fine, fine. Your reactions aren't as fun as Yuri's or Sayori's anyway. Excuse me? Where's Sayori anyway? Oh, there you are. Sayori is sitting at a desk in the corner of the room, looking down at nothing. I walk over to her. Hey, Sayori. I wave my hand in front of her face. You're spacing out again. Sorry. Don't mind me. You can go talk to everyone else. Huh? Is everything alright? Of course. Why wouldn't it be? It just feels like you're a little off. Sorry for assuming things. Jeez, you worry too much about me. I'm fine, see? Sayori shows a big smile. Don't let me distract you from having fun with everyone. Well, alright. If you say so. I worriedly glance at Sayori before turning back toward everyone else. But the conversation has already dispersed, with everyone's back at their usual activities. Maybe I should ask Monika if she's noticed anything about Sayori recently. Since they've been preparing for the festival, they must be spending a lot of time together. I timidly approach Monika, who's shuffling through some papers at her desk. Martin, what's up? This might sound a little bit strange, but have you noticed anything up with Sayori recently? Anything up with her? In what way do you mean? Maybe I'm reading into it a little too much, but she seems a bit downcast today. You think so? I can't say I've noticed anything about her. Monika peers across the room at Sayori, who's idly dragging a rubber eraser up and down her desk. Maybe there's something on her mind. But I'm surprised I'm not the only I'm not the one asking you, Martin. But I'm surprised I'm not the one asking you, Martin. Also, you certainly know a lot better than I do. Yeah, but she's never really like this. She always talked to me about things that bothered her. But this time, when I asked her, she was really dismissive. Sorry, I know it's not your problem. I just wanted to ask if you knew anything, so I'll drop it now. No, no. It's important for me too. I mean, I'm also friends with her, and I also care about the well-being of my club members, you know? Maybe I try talking to her myself. Are you sure about this? She seemed like she wanted to be left alone. Are you sure? Maybe she just had a hard time bringing it up with the person of interest. Person of interest? What do you mean by that? I'm saying that maybe the thing on her mind is you. Me? How on earth would you come to that conclusion? Well, I probably shouldn't say too much, but Sayori talks about you more than anything else, you know? She's been so much happier ever since you joined the club. It's like an extra light was turned on inside of her. What? No way. Sayori's always like that. She's always been full of sunshine. It's not any different now than it always been. You're so funny, Martin. Have you thought that maybe you've always seen her as so cheerful because that's just how she is when she's around you? I said too much. I'm sorry. What do I know anyway? I didn't mean to jump to conclusions, so you should just forget about what I said. I tried to talk to her, so try not to think about it for now. Alright. Monica smiles meaningfully. I know she said to forget about it, but I already know that I won't be able to get her words out of my head. Monica stands up from her desk and walks across the room to where Sayori is sitting. I watch her kneel down next to Sayori and gently talk to her, but she's keeping her voice so quiet that I can't hear from her. Hear her from here. I sigh and sit myself down. I know Sayori told me not to worry about her, have to fun with everyone else, but that's impossible to do when she's behaving like this. Exactly how much do I care about her, that I'm letting this weigh on me down so much? Now it feels like I'm the one behaving out of the ordinary, but there's nothing I can do besides wait for Monica. Why does it feel like I'm being watched? I glance around the room. Suddenly, I notice Yuri peering at me from over her book. But she looks away just as quickly with a flustered look on her face. I realize that she won't get anywhere like this. Entschuldigung, hab ich das wahrscheinlich im Twitch-Chat noch was gelesen? Der Blackout hat mal geschrieben, die Japaner machen sehr oft Wortspiele mit Namen in verschiedenen Schreibweisen und Bedeutungen von Wörtern und Zeichen der japanischen Sprache. Ja. Naja, deswegen. Das war ja auch der Witz, dieser Meta-Witz sozusagen, dass es mit der Übersetzung nicht funktioniert, wie du auch gerade selber geschrieben hast. Gobi meint aber, soweit er weiß, gibt es das Spiel nur in Englisch. Ja, aber dann wäre es ja trotzdem... Ja, interessant auf jeden Fall. I realize that she won't get anywhere like this. I never seen Yuri approach anyone or start a conversation on her own accord. So, I have no choice but to approach her myself. By now, it's a little easier for me to do that. I stand up from my desk and sit in one next to her own. I didn't mean to bother you or anything. Relax, you didn't even do anything. But I couldn't tell that you wanted to be... I could tell that you would... that you wanted to be alone with your thoughts. Alone with my thoughts? How were you even able to tell that I was thinking like that? Well, it's something that I had a lot... that I had to do a lot. So it wasn't hard for me to spot based on your posture and expression. Not that I was staring or anything. I didn't do anything creepy like that. In any case, I guess you were right. I'm sorry if I caused you any concern. Don't apologize. Your troubles are only the concern of those who willingly share in that concern. Of course, there are certainly those who find the most comfort in keeping to themselves. But if you would prefer to share what's on your mind, then I would be glad to listen. That's not really that big of a deal. I was just feeling a bit uneasy about Sayori. Sayori? Yeah, she seems a little bit off today. But when I asked... But when I asked her about it, she didn't want to admit it to me. So I can't help but wonder if something happened to her. Oh. That's quite romantic. Sorry, didn't mean to say something stupid. It's not that, I just didn't want you to misunderstand. Sayori and I have just been friends for a long time, that's all. I see. Then perhaps it's unusual for her to be dismissive to you about her feelings. Or maybe I'm just reading into it a little too much. Martin, the world is full of meaning, often hiding deep beneath plain sight. And there are many untold mysteries behind every person, no matter how well you may know them. So you think that there might be something behind it after all? Hmm. I think that Sayori is a very complex person. Her mannerisms on the outside don't always match what may be going on inside her head. And she may not always know what she wants. I noticed her strange behavior today too. And I also feel some concern for her. But in your case, it looked like she was fully occupying your thoughts, wasn't she? Well, I guess that was the case. Sayori, she really means a lot to you, doesn't she? I guess. But you don't need to put it that way. You're just good friends, that's all. Yuri suddenly looks deeply into my eyes. Her expression is gentle and curious, as if she was searching for something. Embarrassed, I avert my gaze. Sometimes a person's mysteries are untold, even to themselves. And you, as someone honest and caring, maybe uncover feelings you weren't aware were in you. That is, I think that she would be a very fortunate person to have you feel that way about her way. Yuri, you're giving me too much credit. I'm a pretty simple guy. So I think I'm pretty good at understanding my own feelings. I'm not nearly as sophisticated as you. That's not a compliment, is it? It is what it is. Anyway, as long as we're here, why don't we do some reading? Well, as long as you're okay with it. Yeah, I should be taking my mind off this whole thing anyway. Okay, everyone. After some time passes, Monika calls out to the club room. Why don't we share our poems now? Before I know it, everything is back to normal. Everyone goes to retrieve their poems and I do the same. I make eye contact with Monika and she smiles at me. I wonder what she was talking about with Sayori. Tja, in welcher Reihenfolge zeigen wir das denn jetzt mal? Wie habe ich denn sonst angefangen? Ich habe einmal mit Yuri angefangen, einmal mit Monika angefangen. Sunny Hus sagt, ich soll mit Sayori anfangen. Ja, ist ja fast ein bisschen zu offensichtlich. So. Aber andererseits ist es auch eine nette Geste einfach, wenn sie heute nicht so gut geht. Fangen wir mit Sayori an. Mit ihr habe ich auch noch nicht angefangen. Hm, it's nice, I guess. Come on, I can already tell you don't like it. Well, you don't need to worry about what I think. After all, you wrote this for someone else, didn't you? Probably Yuri. I didn't write this for anyone specifically. Maybe. That's not really what I meant, though. But it's okay. You're making new friends, just like I was hoping. That makes me really happy. And you're happy too, right? In this club? Well, of course I am. Good. That's all that matters to me. Thank you, Martin. Sayori, is there something wrong? Huh? No, nothing. I'm just a little tired today. Alright, just tell me if you need anything. I will. Don't worry about me, okay? You can go play with everyone else now. If you insist. Hey, I'm going home a little bit early today. Sayori, tell Monika I wasn't feeling well, okay? I'll see you tomorrow. Before I can say anything else, Sayori cheerfully walks out of the room, humming to herself. Was ist denn jetzt los? Zeigt mir ihr Gedicht nicht? das ganze Tag so komisch und gehe jetzt allein nach Hause. Wie das wohl gelaufen wäre, wenn ich halt ihr nicht gesagt hätte am Vortag, dass ich auch mit Yuri nach Hause gehen würde. Oder, jetzt kommen ja mehrere Sachen zusammen, auch für wen ich die Gedichte schreibe und so. Ach ja. Martin, your writing has only improved in the last few days. Every poem you've shown me has been nothing short of spectacular. I can really feel the emotions. I'm a little bit envious even. I don't think it ever came to me this naturally. Yuri, that's the wrong way to put it. This never did come naturally to me. But I've been able to improve so much thanks to you. You're really the example I was chasing after. Is that so? Yuri gently smiles to herself. This feeling, I'm so glad I got the chance to share my writing. I never thought it would feel like this. I remember you mentioning that yesterday. I can't believe that you're so good at something and you never even shared it with anyone. It's kind of a shame. Maybe, but it's not like I really had a choice. What do you mean? Well, Yuri smiled sadly. Martin, during lunchtime, I eat by myself. Did you know that? It's a great time to find a quiet spot and do some reading. In fact, I always have some books with me. You could say I really enjoy reading. Well, that's one way to put it anyway. But books are so full of amazing and inspiring people. People you want to fall in love with, or people you just know would make really good friends. Cheerful people who always put a smile on your face, or deep thinkers, or problem solvers who discover the mysteries of life. So when you look at it that way, I'm surrounded by friends every day, you know? And those friends don't laugh at me, they don't tease me for spacing out all the time, they don't make fun of my body type, and they don't hate me for acting like I know it all. People say that about you. Ah, jetzt ist der Martin wieder dran. People say that about you. I'm not a know-it-all, Martin. It's the opposite. I don't know anything. I don't know how to talk to people. I don't know how to make people see me as normal. I don't even know how to make myself happy. I have all these feelings, and all I can do with them is read and write. But it wasn't until now that I started sharing it with you that I really understood what was missing all this time. But I haven't really done anything, sagte Martin. No, that's wrong. Just being patient and respectful, that's really important to me. I know I'm a difficult person, Martin. I speak too slowly, I second-guess myself all the time, I read too deeply into things. But every time, you always treated me just like anyone else. It's so rare that I feel comfortable with myself when I talk to others. But that's why every time I talk to you, I just feel really happy. I see. Well, I treat you how you deserve to be treated, Yuri. And if other people don't see it that way, then screw them. I mean, I joined this club hoping I would make some friends. And I would say I've had at least one success. Wouldn't you? If you put it that way, yeah. We really are friends now, aren't we? Yuri puts her head in her hands. But this time she's smiling as she does it. Do you want me to show you a poem? Do you want to show me your poem? Yeah, I do. Let me get it for you. Ghost Under the Light Part 2. The tendrils of my hair illuminate beneath the amber glow, bathing. In the distances, a blue-green light flickers. A lone figure crosses its path, a silhouette obstructing the eerie glow. My heart pounds, the silhouette close, closer, closer. I open my umbrella, casting a shadow to shield me from visibility. But I'm too late. He steps into the streetlight, I gasp and drop my umbrella. The light flickers, my heart pounds, he raises his arm. Time stops. The only indication of movement is the amber light flickering against his outstretched arm. The flickering light is in rhythm with the pounding of my heart, teasing me for succumbing to his forbidden emotion. Have you ever heard of ghosts feeling warmth before? Give him up on understanding, I love. Understanding is overrated. I touch his hand, the flickering stops. Ghosts are blue-green, my heart is amber. Finishing the poem, I start to hand it back to Yuri. But instead of taking it from me, she looks away. Do you dislike it? No, of course not. I just don't really know how I should respond. Despite Yuri's poems usually being cryptic, it wasn't hard to figure out what this one was about. I don't know if I'll be able to explain this one. That's fine. I understand this one. Yuri is having an even harder time speaking than usual. Does this mean a lot to you? Yuri nods. I'm not really good with words, but I'm happy that you shared it with me. So thank you. And I hope you keep spending time together. Despite my inability to make eye contact, I see a faint smile emerge on Yuri's lips. I once again try to hand the poem back to her. But instead, Yuri gently takes my hands and pushes them back towards me. I hesitate in response to her warm touch. You can... The poem is... Once again, Yuri fails to form a complete sentence. You mean I can keep it? Yuri nods. I'd love to. Again, Yuri faintly smiles as she doesn't want me to notice. You always make me feel nice. I know I'm not good with people, but I hope that I can return the favor sometimes. Yeah, don't worry. I think you do a good job. Yuri finally turns back towards me. I guess we should move on before Monika says something, but I'm sure we can talk again later. Yeah, I'm sure we will. With that, Yuri timidly smiles at me and I return to my seat so I can put her poem away. Das, dann kann sie ihr Gedicht nicht mit anderen teilen. Vielleicht hat sie das ja auch schon gemacht. So, nehmen wir diesmal Monika als letztes. Yeah, no thanks. You didn't even... Next. Der Kaiser hat ja geschrieben, dass er seine Gedichte auf die Natsuki geschrieben hat und mit er da irgendwie mehr zusammen gemacht hat, auch schon am ersten Tag. Nächstes Mal jetzt dann mit ihr die Mangas statt dieses Buch, was ich halt mit der Yuri angefangen habe. Aber die Natsuki hatte gar keinen Bock mehr auf mich. Hi Martin, have you thought about what you want to submit to perform at the festival? Well, being in this club is one thing, but performing in front of a bunch of people, I have to give it some more thought. Okay, no pressure. But whatever you do, I'm sure it will turn out great. It would also make me happy to see. Anyway, let's take a look at today's poem. Sure. I let Monika take the poem I'm holding in my hands. Your style's gotten refined, Martin. Yuri's been teaching you a lot of things, hasn't she? Well, I guess so. Yeah, I've been noticing how much time you spend with her. I think I've heard her say more words these past couple days than she's talked in the whole year. Not sure how you did it, but that's pretty impressive. Well, she just needs some patience and a way to talk about all the things in her head, I guess. I'm still getting the hang of it myself. You're certainly putting in a lot of effort. You must really like her. It's awfully suspicious, you know? Spending time with her in the club room every day. Reading that edgy novel with her. Well, I just feel bad that she has a hard time socializing. It makes me want to make sure she doesn't spend all her time alone. Besides, the novel isn't too bad either, you know? Alright. I get you. Just be careful, alright? I know that Yuri isn't used to opening herself up. So if something bad happens while she's vulnerable, then it could really be hard for her. Her books aren't a total escape from reality. They're just a bandage. You say that like I'm going to hurt her. Sorry, I didn't really mean that. If anything, she might accidentally hurt herself. Anyway, I'll share my poem with you right now, alright? Alright. The Lady Who Knows Everything. An old tale tells of a lady who wanders Earth. The lady who knows everything. A beautiful lady who has found every answer, all meaning, all purpose, and all that was ever sought. And here I am, a feather, lost adrift the sky, victim of the current of the wind. Day after day I search. I search with little hope, knowing legends don't exist. But when all else has failed me, when all others have turned me away, or have turned away, the legend is that all that remains, the last dim star glimmering in the twilight sky. Until one day the wind ceases to blow, I fall. And I fall and fall and fall even more, gentle as a feather, a tranquil, expressionless. But a hand catches me between a thumb and forefinger, the hand of a beautiful lady. I look at her eyes and find no end to her gaze. The lady who knows everything knows what I'm thinking. Before I can speak, she responds in a hollow voice. I have found every answer, all of which amount to nothing. Wo war ich jetzt? Achso, okay. There's no meaning, there's no purpose, and we seek only the impossible. I'm not your legend does not exist. And with a breath, she blows me back afloat and pick up a gust of wind. You know, I feel like learning and looking for answers are the sort of things that give life meaning. Not to get too philosophical or anything, but it was kind of... Mann, reiß dich mal zusammen, Helly. But it was kind of on my mind, so that's what I wrote about. I see. I never really put much thought into it. In a way, it's almost paradoxical, because if we had all the answers, wouldn't the world start to lose its meaning? You know, there's one thing I noticed. It seems like everyone in the club prefers writing about things that are more sad than happy. You're surprised? I mean, if everything was okay, we wouldn't really have anything to write about, would we? Humans aren't two-dimensional creatures. I think you'd know that better than anyone. You mean one-dimensional? Ah, yeah, that. Okay, da haben wir das nächste. Den nächsten weird moment mit Monika. Ganz interessant übrigens, Kaizo hat das vorhin mit mir angefangen, aber da er nicht vorliest, kann man natürlich schneller das spielen und meint, die Warnung, die man am Anfang hört, ist berechtigt oder die man am Anfang des Spiels bekommt. Bin ich ja gespannt. Auf jeden Fall ist mit der Monika wieder ein weiterer Hinweis mit eindimensional und zweidimensional. Man sagt jetzt sonst eindimensional, wenn halt was nicht so einfach ist oder halt komplexer als es anscheinend hat, weil sie hätte zweidimensional gesagt. Wie halt das Spiel ist, ne? Wie halt mit dem Laden und was war es noch mit der Übersetzung und noch irgendwas hatten wir. Das eine habe ich vergessen, eine Sache davon, aber interesting. Anyway, here's Monika's writing tip of the day. Are you ever too shy to share your writing because you're afraid that it's not good? It can be really disheartening to get a lukewarm response to something you put so much into. But if you find other people who enjoy writing, then sharing becomes a lot easier. Because instead of just telling you that your writing is good, or okay, or bad, they want to focus more on everything that went into it, and the things you can work on. It's much more encouraging that way, and it will make you want to continue improving. It's almost like having your own little literature club, don't you think? That's my advice for today. Thanks for listening. Okay, you three. We are all done sharing poems, right? Why don't we start figuring out... Hold on a second. Is it just me, or did you say something strange just now? Something did sound a bit unusual. That's right. You deviated from your usual catchphrase when addressing the club. Catchphrase? I don't have a catchphrase. Jeez. Why is the mood so weird today? Look, even Yuri isn't immune to it. Stagnating air is commonly foreshadowing that something terrible is about to happen. Okay. In your books, maybe. Look, the only thing different is that Sayori isn't here. It seems you're right. Sayori always helps lighten the mood a little bit, doesn't she? It's almost like everyone's balance is thrown off a little when she's not around. Where the heck did she run off to anyway? I thought she just went to pee. Natsuki, please, show some decency. Come on. She actually wasn't feeling too well, and she went home early. Is that so? I hope she's alright. seriously, of all the times to not go home with her, you pick the time she's not feeling well. So much for you two being all lovey-dovey. No. First of all, stop misunderstanding my friendship with Sayori. And second, she kind of been avoiding me today, so I didn't want to force it. Huh? That curious expression coming from Yuri of all people? Calm down, guys. I talked to her earlier and everything is fine. What did she say? Anyway, we need to figure out the rest of the festival preparations. So let's decide what everyone will be doing this weekend. I already know what I'm doing. That's right. Natsuki will be making cupcakes, but we might need a lot of them and different flavors. Can you handle all that by yourself, Natsuki? Challenge accepted. And as for myself, I'm going to be printing and assembling all the poetry pamphlets. Sayori will be helping me design them. And as for you, Yuri, you can... Guys, can you help me come up with something for Yuri? I'm useless. No, that's not it at all. You're the most talented person here, you know? Pfft. Now Natsuki's pouting too? Jeez, even I can't tell now. I guess I never gave Sayori enough credit, but I can tell things are even harder on you when she's not around. That may be the case. But if I can't also be the leader on my own, then I won't grow as a person. So Yuri, you have beautiful handwriting, you know? So you should make some banners and decorations to help set the atmosphere. Atmosphere? About that. I love atmosphere. Yuri's expression suddenly changes as she stares at her desk in focus and starts nodding to herself. Your mind is already racing, I see. It's great. You'll be wonderful. You'll be a wonderful help, Yuri. But anyway, it just leaves you, Martin. The one who is truly useless. Don't say that. In fact, both Natsuki and Yuri have some pretty heavy tasks to handle. It would probably go a long way to give one of them a hand. You could always help me out as well. I would be really appreciative of that. Is Monika suggesting I spend the weekend with one of my club members? How on earth are they going to respond to a suggestion like that? I suppose I wouldn't mind a bit of help. Well, even if you don't know how to bake, there's always some dirty work I could give to you. It's not like Monika's going to give me a choice and you shouldn't be sitting on your butt anyway. Natsuki tries to mumble a bunch of excuses like that. If I recall, Natsuki, you mentioned that you would like to handle the baking on your own. Marty may not like to be around if you only make him out to be a nuisance. So therefore, he may be more suited to assisting with the decorations. Hold on, I never said that. How hard could it be to make a few decorations anyway? Sounds more like you're just making excuses for Martin to... What are you saying? It would be extremely meticulous work. And baking isn't. Just what do you think? Guys, let's settle down for a moment. In the end, I think it's up to Martin to decide how he'd like to contribute. Besides, he hasn't really gotten a chance to spend any time with me yet, you know? So I'm sure he's interested in... You literally just said, I'm surprised as well. Sorry. I was just saying, though. Can we just settle this already? Yeah. Martin, you're okay with this, right? In the end, it's up to you. Of course. Very well. In that case, everyone looks straight at me. But of course, I'm going to go with... Muss mich entscheiden. Also wer mich mal rausfällt, ist Natsuki. Die schnauzt mich halt die ganze Zeit nur an. Sagt, dass sie mir eh nur Scheißarbeit geben möchten. Von daher, nee. Die restlichen Optionen sind ein bisschen interessanter. Am nettesten klingt es halt, Zeit mit der Yuri zu verbringen. Außerdem hat sie auch gesagt, dass sie gerne meine Hilfe möchte. Die Monika wird interessant, weil man von der halt überhaupt nichts weiß. Und Sayori wäre halt einfach ganz... Weil irgendwie geht es ja anscheinend nicht so gut. Und es hat schon damit zu tun, was da auf dem Heimweg passiert ist und so. Und dass sie irgendwie vielleicht ein bisschen eifersüchtig ist. Aber es bringt ja auch, nicht weiter. Interessant wäre Monika oder Yuri eigentlich. Ne, Sayori, ja, ist auch was. Man kann speichern, oder? Ha. Aber gehen wir einfach noch mal spontan. Ich wollte schon gerade im Twitch-Chat gesagt, ich soll speichern, alles mal ausprobieren. Kann man vielleicht später mal machen. Aber tatsächlich nehmen wir die Yuri. Folgen wir unserem Herzen. Well, I'll probably be most useful. Probably be most useful helping out Yuri. Me? Are you serious? Why would you? Natsuki, I can already tell you're about to say something mean. No, I was just saying... So you'll be helping Yuri then? You'll be helping Yuri then, Martin? Yeah, that's what I'm going to do. I'm glad. I have a bad habit of overthinking these sort of things, so I think your assistance will be very useful. That's great to hear. Natsuki, will you be able to handle the baking yourself? I mean, yeah. I already said I would be fine. Okay, okay. Everyone can tell that Natsuki is feeling a little sour. So, is that everything we need to go over? Yeah, that should be about it. Are you guys excited? Well, excited may not be the right word, but I suppose I'm looking forward to it a little bit. Do you feel the same way, Martin? Me? I guess you could say I'm interested to see how it will turn out. That's good enough for me. What about you, Natsuki? Natsuki? What? Why is everyone yelling at me? I didn't even do anything. No, that's not what I meant at all. Yuri anxiously glances between everyone in the room. I'm sorry for this. I don't really know why Martin picked me. And also, your cupcakes are the best cupcakes I ever had. They go really well with my tea. And nothing that I do for the event will compare to that, so... So... I get it. I'm kinda surprised, though. Why? Well, I'm the one acting immature. I already know that. But you're trying to cheer me up all of a sudden... I know, I'm not very good at it. I'm sorry if I said something bad. Natsuki isn't the only one surprised. Monika and I are... also taken aback by Yuri's words. When she already has trouble with words, trying to cheer someone up must be far out of her comfort zone. But I begin to understand. Yuri was trying to sound like Sayori. Even if it didn't work perfectly, I can tell that she tried to say something Sayori would say at a time like this. Because Sayori always helps everyone smile and feel good about themselves. No, I kinda appreciated it. I'm sorry for making a big deal out of nothing. But I'm going to say this. You better bet that my cupcakes are going to be the best part of the whole event. I believe you. Yeah, I hope you see everyone do their best. But with that, there's nothing more for today. So I guess it's time for us to head out. Alright, let's get out of here then. Ich dachte gerade, das kommt aus dem Spiel. Das ist aber tatsächlich, was Richtiges. Ich habe gerade einen Anruf bekommen. Ja, nicht jetzt. Mach das mal zu. Kümmere ich mich mal gleich drum. Everyone packs up their things. I start to follow Monika and Natsuki out of the door as they chat between each other. Dann bleiben wir mit Yuri noch alleine hier. Yuri spricht mich nochmal an. Wir speichern es nochmal, dann spiele ich dann mal weiter. Ich muss mich mal kurz um meinen Anruf kümmern. Und meldet mich dann gleich wieder. Wir werden noch ein bisschen weiterspielen. Ich bin jetzt aber gespannt, wann es halt weitergeht. oder wie es weitergeht, wie es halt jetzt in den spannenden Stellen kommt. Und bevor ich mich verabschiede, noch ein Dank an QQ Onyx, inzwischen 35 Monate Abonnent. 35 verfickte Axt. Da haben wir bald die 3 Jahre voll. Also, dann sehen wir uns gleich wieder, wenn es weitergeht mit Doki Doki Literature Club. Bis dann.